reputed national and international journals and had several books to his credit. His research fields include fractional geometry, information theory, calculation theory, ecological and epidemic modeling in mathematical biology. Today his topic is dynamics of ACAITL model with saturated treatment, a case study of Spain COVID-19. Let me now hand over the microphone. Sir, the microphone is all yours now.
Okay. Shida, I have to start.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Okay, I am audible to all.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Yes.
You are audible, sir.
First, I want to acknowledge Vishwajitha, Honorable Principal, Sujitha.
Thank you.
Sujitha, that two person is from, I am from their department because they are in Applied Mathematics department before me. So they are my elder brothers.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Dada.
Thank you.
Another elder, Kaushikda, is on the participant list. Okay, Kaushikda also, the IPOC coordinator, Ajayda, and my sister. Lastly,
thank you.
Haida sir, thanks to him for giving concern again and again for different webinar in India from my request. And I thank participants for attending this webinar. But I changed the title change in title, Use of Mathematical Modeling in COVID-19 Dynamics and Control. First, my objective, I have divided the lecture into two parts. First part is application of differential equation, the stability analysis, that is qualitative analysis of the differential equation, that is stability, bifurcation, this type of, then, and with the basic epidemic model and the different incident rate, treatment rate, etc. And second part, its application to COVID-19 model. Okay. First, stability analysis of the solution of the differential equation. First, I consider here a one variable, that is one independent and one dependent variable differential equation dx dt is equal to f. If this is a linear differential equation, then we can find the solution easily. This is an easy job. But if it is not linear, that is the right hand side is not linear or not integrable. That is, if I produce dx by fx is equal to dt, and if I am not able to integrate the function explicitly, then the mathematician does something new. That new is the qualitative analysis, that is qualitative analysis of the solution in vicinity of the equilibrium points. What is equilibrium point? Equilibrium point means that point where the flow is zero, that is where there is no velocity. Or in other words, for our model, for our my equation, here dx dt is equal to 0, that is f of x is equal to 0 at that point. This is known as the fixed point or equilibrium point. Suppose in our case x equal to x0 is a is an equilibrium point, then f of x0 is equal to 0. Now use the transformation x equal to x0 plus u, and the first, where u is very, very small, then the put it in the first equation, and it will reduce to this form, dy dt is a.
You are not audible. Sound is.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you. I think you should unmute yourself. Your sound is not audible.
Sorry.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Now you are audible. Yeah.
Okay. Now I again repeat. Now consider the differential equation, first order differential equation, and with the right hand side, that is dx dt equal to fx is nonlinear. That is, we are not able to integrate this function explicitly. In this situation, is it showing here? The slide is showing?
Yes, sir. The slides are shown. Yes, sir. You can go ahead.
Okay. Now, suppose x equal to x0 is a fixed point of fx, of the above differential equation. That is, fixed point means at the point where the growth of the function, growth of the left hand side is 0, that is dx dt is equal to 0.
Hello, sir.
Okay.
The slide is not visible.
Slide is not visible?
Yes, sir. Uttam Ghosh, sir. Slide is not visible.
You just pin yourself. You just pin the presentation.
Uttam Ghosh, sir. Slide is not
visible. Excuse me, sir. The slide is not visible in full screen. Please maximize this screen.
Okay, now this is maximized form.
Not yet, sir.
Is it okay?
Not yet, sir.
Another someone is presenting. I think Kumar Napoleon.
Yeah.
Kumar Napoleon, dekha hai.
This is Kumar N. Who is Kumar N?
Please stop your presentation, please.
Okay, now is visible.
Participant, please don't share. Don't.
Not yet, sir. It is in minimized form.
But it is in my computer. This is full screen. This is Kumar.
There is a Napoleon Deka.
Kumar Napoleon Deka, please come.
Okay.
Please.
Now,
please remove your screen from here.
It's okay.
Yes.
You may continue now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will. Okay. Now I'm starting. Now I am again starting from the initial. I consider the differential equation dx dt is equal to fx with fx as nonlinear function. As fx is nonlinear function, so we are not able, if we are able to integrate the function properly, then it is okay. But if it is not integrable properly, then we find the quality to solution in vicinity of the equilibrium point. Thus, what is equilibrium? The equilibrium point is a point where the growth is zero, that is where dx dt is equal to zero. That is, if f of x is equal to zero, suppose
at x is f of x0 is equal to 0. Then we use the transformation x equal to x0 plus u and put in the given equation, but u is very, very small. So that we can neglect the higher order term of u, that is from u square to onward. Then the differential will reduce to du by dt is equal to f of x0 plus u. Now use the Taylor's expansion.
Hello, Uttam sir. Uttam go, sir. Sorry, sir. Sir, still presentation slide is not visible.
Still not visible. What is happening?
Slide is visible, sir. Slide is absolutely visible. I think the participant who is complaining, you should check your internet connection or pin the presentation in your mobile. So your slide is absolutely visible. You carry on.
Okay, I'm continuing. Now, so the du dt is equal to, after Taylor's expansion, f of x0 plus u into, u into f dot x0. First term will vanish. So second term is u into f dot x0.
Hello, sir. Hello. It is not visible.
After integration, after integration, it becomes u t is equal to c into to the power f dot x0 into t. Now, if f dot x0 is positive, then when t tends to infinity, then u t tends to infinity. And when f dot x0 is negative, then when t tends to infinity, then u t tends to 0. That is, the sign of f dot x0 is most important for stability of the solution. What is stability? Here, we mean stability means with t tends to infinity, if the value, if the solution curve goes towards a finite value, then this is a stable solution. Otherwise, this is an unstable solution. And this function, this value f dot x0, it is the growth rate of the considered equation. Now I consider a system of linear equation. Dx dt is equal to a11x plus a12y, dy dt is equal to a21x plus a22y. And I put the solution in, where target is to find the solution in terms of exponential function. So we are putting xt is equal to c1 exp plus c2 into y2 is equal to c2 exp. Then what is happening? Then after putting this value in the given differential equation, the differential equation reduces to a system of linear equation. But what is happening? This is a linear equation in terms of C1, C2, and this is a homogeneous equation. So for non-zero, non-trivial solution, that is for at least C1, C2, at least one of them not equal to zero, we must have the value of the determinant of this coefficient zero. That is, this is equal to zero. And this is a second degree equation. This you can written this form. And suppose this has two roots, lambda 1 and lambda 2. If V1, V2 are the corresponding eigenvectors, then the solution can be written in the form xy is equal to c1, v1, exp lambda 1t plus c2, v2, exp lambda 2t. Now, three cases may happen. Suppose lambda 1, lambda 2 both real and unequal. In this case, this is solution. In this solution, if lambda 1, lambda 2 both are positive, then what will happen? As t tends to infinity, that is xy goes to infinity. So this is unstable solution. If lambda 1, lambda 2 both negative, then with t tends to infinity, xy goes to 0, that is stable solution. And if one lambda is positive and one lambda is negative, one part goes to infinity and another part goes to zero, as a whole total solution goes to infinity. And this type of solution along one path it converges to the it try to go to the fixed point that is zero here, and along another path it try to go infinity. I will discuss using the figure some. And when both roots are equal, that is lambda 1 equal to lambda 2 is equal to lambda, then suppose v2 is the generalized eigenvector, in this case the solution will be xy is equal to c1 v1 exp lambda plus c2 into v1 t plus v2. And when lambda 1 lambda 2 both are complex, that is lambda 1 equal to alpha plus minus I beta, the solution will be in this form c1 v1 into exp lambda one value and c2 v2 exp another value. I beta part will give the oscillatory part. If I take common the e to the power alpha t, then the second part will produce the cosine part, and the second part will give the corresponding oscillatory part, and the first part will give the corresponding time dependent amplitude of the solutions. When t tends to infinity, here two cases may occur. First case, alpha positive. If alpha is positive, then when t tends to infinity, the solution asymptotically with oscillation will converge towards infinity. And when alpha less than zero, then with increasing of time, it will oscillate and converge towards the origin here. And when alpha is equal to zero, then center-like solution, that is depending on the initial point, a cycle will form connecting the initial point. Now for nonlinear system of differential equation, dx dt is equal to f of xy and dy dt is equal to g of xy. Suppose beta x0 y0 is the equilibrium point. If this is a linear system, then we can find the solution using the previous method. But if it's non-linear, that is, if it is non-linear, then we cannot, then sometimes we are not able to find the exact solution. Suppose in this situation, x0, y0 be the fixed point or equilibrium point. That is, in this situation, f of x0, y0 equal to 0, and g of x0 is equal to.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you again. Somebody muted you. I think you should unmute yourself.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, you zeta is equal to x minus x0 and eta is equal to y minus y0. Then the given system reduced to this form. Di dt, d eta dt is equal, this is the linear part and this is non-linear part. But the linear values are a11 is equal del f by del x at x0, y0, a12 del f by del y at x0, y0, and so on. To find the solution, we will consider the linear part only. The non-linear part will discuss here. Now, okay, suppose x0 y0 is the equilibrium point and the linear part has roots both negative real, and v1 v2 the eigenvectors represent that this is the eigenvector, this is the eigenvector, and both are inward direction here. In this situation, if I start from any equilibrium point in this plane, then if what is happening here? Again and again the microphone.
Yes, sir. Participants, please do not mess with the microphone of the speaker. I request repeatedly, let him speak smoothly. Please don't mess with his microphone.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. You
can. Yeah. In this situation, if I start from the upper side, I will go towards the equilibrium point through the along this type of trajectory, and if I start from the lower side, I will go along this side of trajectory. And in this case, zero is a stable node. We call the equilibrium point as the stable node when both the root are negative real. If one root is negative and one is positive, in this case, this is the blue line of the vector direction, and this is the for negative eigenvalue, as it that will this will converge towards the equilibrium point, and this is for the and this is for the positive eigenvalue roots vector. In this case, this point is known as the saddle point. And in this situation, if I start from this point, that is from the left upper point, then that as T will try to move towards the origin, and there is certain region when the trajectory will reach that point, then it will move outward along the other vector. That is, that's still stable, and if I start from any equilibrium point, the system will not diverge from the equilibrium point. And when both roots have positive roots, in this case, this is the eigenvectors, both are from outward direction. And in this case, if I start from any point in the neighborhood of the equilibrium point, that is in our case 0, 0, it will diverge in outward direction. Now, when the roots are complex with negative real part, in this case, this is another stable spiral, and the solution here asymptotically stable. In this situation, if I start from any point of the place plane, the solution spirally moves towards the equilibrium point, that is 0, 0 here. And for unstable spiral, that is when both the roots have positive real part. In this case, if I start from the in vicinity of the equilibrium point, it will go outwards on the equilibrium point through a spiral path. This is known as the unstable spiral. Now the basic epidemic model, the well-known MK model, this is three-dimensional model I had discussed. This is a three-compartmental model, SIR model. DSDT is equal to minus beta SI, that is, this is the rate of change of S class. The susceptible pupil, S is the susceptible pupil, I is the at this point, in the right hand side, 1 minus alpha by beta into S is equal to 0. Suppose this occurs at S equal to S1, then S1 is equal to alpha by beta. And this is a critical size. If at S equal to alpha by beta, I will be maximum. Now I discard it. If I integrate this equation and use the initial conditions, suppose initial conditions are S0 and I0. After integration, this becomes I is equal to I0 plus S0 minus this. Now rewrite the log part in this form. Ln s by h0 is equal to 1 minus bracket 1 minus s by h0, and use the expansion of logarithm. I can write this line in this form, I0 plus this. Now, if this part is positive, then with the increase of, and this is this is small, in this case, with the increase of this, if this part is positive, with the increase of t, the number of infected population will increase. And if this is negative, and then the number of infected population will decrease from the initial value. So this value plays an important role. I will denote it by R0 is equal to beta into H0 by alpha. Further, I will discuss about the basic reproduction number. This R0 is here like the basic reproduction number. And if this R0 is greater than 1, that is, bit portion is positive, then with the increase of t, the number of infected population will decrease. That is, disease will spread. And if R0 less than 1, then this part is negative. And then with the increase of time, I will decrease. That is, the disease will die out from the system after some time. So this is the basic reproduction number R0. And in main model, I will discuss you about the basic reproduction number and how we can calculate using the standard methodology. Now, in the first model, in the first equation, we have found this is beta SI, this is the rate of incidence. And there are many type of rate of incidence. That is, the first is the beta SI. I write here only beta. When S class will come here, then this is beta SI. And beta SI is the bilinear incident rate. This, but when a large number of people becomes infected in the system, then the populations, the society will take awareness. That is, they will take precaution. In this case, what will happen? In this case, the number of infected population will decrease, and it will, the incident rate will reach a saturated value. In this case, we consider saturated type incident rate. And when alpha is lower, when number of infected population is lower, this value is lower. But with the increase of I, this value will increase, and the max value will be, if I divide both sides by I and I is infinity, this is really beta by alpha. So there is a saturated level. And another is the non-monotonic functional rate. That is, in the previous two cases, with the increase of, in the first case, with the increase of I, the rate of incidence is increasing. In the second case, with the increase of I, the rate of infection is increasing and reaches a saturated value beta by alpha. And in third cases, non-monotonic case, with the increase of I, first the portion will increase and increase up to a certain value, then it will start to decrease. And this type of rate of infection is used when the disease stay in a system for very short time period. Suppose the SARS, MERS, this like of disease stay in the system 1, 3, or 4, 5 months. In those cases, to model the dynamics of those disease, we usually use this type of incident rate. Now, another is the treatment rate. There are various type of treatment. The first type, TI is equal to RI. That is, in this model, the treatment, okay, I will discuss. R0 equal to, I will discuss further. When TI is equal to RI, then in model purpose, with the increase of number of infected population, the treatment capacity is increasing. But we are seeing the real picture in this situation in the world, due to huge number of infected population by due to COVID, so we are not able to provide a treatment to every COVID infection. So this model again and again modified by the authors, and the most important model is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is TI is equal to AI by B, 1 plus BI. With the increase of I, we can give we can increase the number of the treatment facility, but we have a limited capacity throughout the world. That is, in our case, with the increase of I, when I tends to infinity, the treatment amount will reach the value, max value A by B, then we will not able to provide their treatment. And this is the bed limitation case. This is mu1 is the maximum number of bedded, and mu0 is the minimum number of bedded. When B is equal to 0, then mu0 is the minimum number of bed will be used. And when I tends to infinity, when I is equal to 0, then mu0 will cancel, that is maximum facility of bed. And when I tends to infinity, then mu0, that is this portion is 0, that is we are able to provide minimum facility. Now the COVID-19 model. The COVID-19, that is coronavirus. The coronavirus was identified in China, that is Hubei, in December 2019, and the common symptom includes fever, cough, fatigue, and shortness of breath, that is most important throughout the world, and loss of smell and taste. And due to COVID, a large number of people is suffering for shortness of breath. In COVID-19, that is in Corona, the two important feature in our case throughout the world is happening. One is the asymptomatic patient, that is those patients are infected and they are infectious but not showing any infection, and those persons are most dangerous for spreading the disease. And another is the till date there is no vaccine or proper treatment from the corona. Now this is a 6-compartmental model, that is this is susceptible class, that is this is exposed class, this is the asymptomatic class. That is what is happening here, S class when interact with the infected, that is I class and the asymptomatic class, they became infected, but they are not infectious. That is, we already read in the paper, that is not usual paper, the period, a corona infected people becomes infectious after 2 to 14 days, that is incubation period of the corona infected patient. In this case, so this is the susceptible class, this class is named exposed class, that is the class those are infected but not infectious, that is not infecting the disease. Now here we divide this class into 3 parts: the asymptomatic, this is the symptomatic, that is asymptomatic and in hospitalized for our case, and this is the quarantine people. And the quarantine people, after some time they become recovered and they become again infected, they show the symptom, then they will go to the I class. And the asymptomatic cases, after test they may be in hospitalized, and this is the recovery rate and the treated, and there is a diagnostic, this will be AR. Now this is our model, DSDT is equal to, this is the birth rate, and this is the infection rate. That is what infection rate? When S class interact with the I class or A class, then they become infectious. And this is the alpha is the coefficient for A, that is rate of infection. When S class come with interaction with the A class, that is asymptomatic class, and beta is the rate of infection when the S class interact with the I class. And this is the normal death rate. So this term will come to the exposed class, and this will divide three parts. One to the asymptomatic, and second is the quarantine, and third is the symptomatic and in hospital. And this is the facility of hospital, that is, we have limited facility. So here we take the limited treatment rate, and after treatment, after treatment, this will go to the R class. Now, this class has the disease free equilibrium. That equilibrium means where disease is zero. If I put in this equation, right hand side, taking right hand side equal to zero, and put A E I is equal to zero, and obviously I get the value of S equal to A by alpha, and E0, A0, E0, I0, also R equal to 0. So this is the disease-free equilibrium point. When disease-free equilibrium point exists in the system, then using the next generation metric approach, we can find the basic reproduction number. What is basic reproduction number? Basic reproduction number is the number of secondary infected population due to a single infected single primary infected population. That is, a primary infected population infects the how many number of the susceptible people. That is the basic reproduction number. And this basic reproduction number, plays an important role for controlling the disease. In our case, this is the F class. This class is spreading the disease, and this class the remaining part, we have to find F is equal to the value of del F by del Xj. Xj means the variables at E0, and V equal to del F by del V by del Xj at E0. Then the next generation matrix is the dominant eigenvalue of F inverse. For our case, this is the value of R0. This R0 is two part. One part, this is the part comes from the asymptomatic pupil, that is F due to alpha, and this part comes from the symptomatic pupil, that is those pupil are in hospital. Now the endemic equilibrium point. The system contains the endemic equilibrium point in this form, and S star I star is given here, but E star satisfies the third degree equation, and depending the sign of C0, C1, C2, C3, the number of equilibrium, the number of endemic equilibrium point will generate. What is endemic equilibrium point? Endemic equilibrium point means when the disease persists in the system but not spreading highly. This is the endemic, disease persists in the system. Now, the stability of the disease equilibrium point. The disease equilibrium point will be stable when R0 less than 1 and unstable when R0 greater than 1. This is the Jacobian matrix at this point, we already know this. And this equation, JE0 has 6 eigenvalue, 2 are minus epsilon minus epsilon, and other 4 are satisfied this polynomial equation. Since 2 roots are negative, if other 4 values are negative, then the equilibrium point will be stable. And if other 4 are, at least one of them is positive, then it will be unstable. It can be shown that P0 is equal to, if I put 0 here, P0 is equal to R0 minus 1. Now when R0 greater than 1, then P0 is positive. And when lambda tends to infinity, then this term all goes to zero, so p infinity is equal to minus one. That is, there is at least one sign change between zero and infinity. The disease equilibrium point is unstable. Okay. Now, when R0 less than 1, using the Rx criteria, we can find easily the stability condition. We can find easily the stability of the equilibrium point. Now, backward bifurcation. I describe in the figure. The backward bifurcation means this is most important for the controlling of disease. We established in the previous theorem, when R0 less than 1, then the equilibrium point is stable. That is, disease will eliminate. There exists another another endemic equilibrium point which is stable. That is, in this situation, R0 less than 1 not sufficient condition for controlling the disease. In figure, when R0 less than 1, that is up to this point, the disease equilibrium point is stable. And when R0 greater than 1, the disease equilibrium point is unstable. That has two terms. The low infection, equilibrium point is unstable. And with higher level of infection, the equilibrium point is stable. In this situation, the controlling of disease depends not only it also depends on the initial number of population. Now the methodology and the
Sir, you are muted again. Uttam sir, you are muted again, I think. Your voice is not audible.
Okay, this is okay.
Yes, now it's okay.
This is okay now? Okay. Who is doing this?
Yeah. We can take this. Okay. I don't know. I apologize on their behalf.
Okay, no problem. Now, suppose R0 equal to 1 occurs for the parametric value alpha. That is alpha equal to at this point. And when R0 equal to 1, we already shown previously how.
Again, somebody muted.
So?
Okay.
Sir, again, you are mute. Please, I request the participants not to interfere with the speaker's speech. Please, I request all of you repeatedly.
Okay. Now, it is okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When R0 equal to 1, suppose this occurs for alpha equal to alpha BB, that is alpha backward bifurcation here. And in this situation, the system contains three eigenvalues. Those are 0 minus epsilon minus epsilon, and another satisfy the third degree equation. And if all the roots of this third degree equation are negative, then suppose at alpha equal to BB, that is the corresponding 0 eigenvalue, the right eigenvectors are these and left eigenvectors are these. Then we have to calculate two quantities, that is phi and psi. Phi is equal to this and psi is equal to this. If both phi and psi are positive at this value, then the system will experience the backward bifurcation. Now, data fitting. The data fitting is most important for epidemic model. That is, we can estimate the model parameters using the data fitting analysis. Suppose yi is the cumulative number of infected population that is collected from the real field, and j theta I is the cumulative number of infected population predicted from the model. Then j will satisfy this equation. Dz dt is equal to, and that is delta a plus gamma 3i plus q1a. Now, using MATLAB package, our target is to estimate the model parameters such that the standard error, that is estimated value, estimated from the model value, and from the real data, their square difference is minimum. And using the MATLAB package, we found the model parameters are these. And this is the sensitivity index. What is sensitivity index? Here, this sensitivity index is the sensitivity due to the sensitivity index of the basic reproduction number. If the sensitivity index are positive, then with the increase of those parameters, the basic reproduction number will increase. And consequently, the number of infected population will increase. And for the second case, if the sensitive index are negative, then with the increase of the corresponding variable, the basic reproduction number will decrease and disease can be controlled easily. Now this is the data fit. Here, the blue lines are the model prediction and the red dot are the original data. This is best fitted curve, and this is the infected data, and this is the corresponding histogram. That is bar diagram, sorry, this is a bar diagram. And this is the residual. Since here the residual is distributed uniformly, that's randomly distributed, so the data fit can be said as this is a good data fit. Now, this is the effect of the model parameter mu1. With the increase of here, we increase the model parameter mu1. Here we increase the model parameter mu1 20% above and 20% below. That is 20% increase and 20% decrease. In our case, the red curve denotes the model predicted solution curve, and this is after 20% increase and this is after 20% decrease. Similarly, this is for the model parameter gamma. Now I will go to another slide. Okay, this is visible.
Yes,
okay.
Sir, it's visible.
Yes.
Okay. Now, contribution of R0 in the infection, the infectious class and the asymptomatic class. Here, our R0 contains two parts. I previously told it. I named them R01 and R02. And putting the model estimated parameters value, we got the value of R0 is 6.6925, and R01 is 5.2. That is, the those person asymptomatic and outside the hospital, and R02 is equal to 1.39 for Spain case. That is, the hospitalized person contributing 21% spreading infection. And the other, the person here outside from the hospital, they are contributing 79% spreading. Now, estimation of the actual epidemic.
what is actual epidemic? Usually, the epidemic, in epidemic case, epidemic first start and then it reaches to the max point. In this situation, when the epidemic is increasing, in this situation, what is the growth rate? For this purpose, suppose at the initial point, the number of initial population was lambda by epsilon, and we take AT, PT, QT, and IT in this form, that is A0 into exponential zeta T, that zeta is the force of infection, that's a growth rate, and putting these values in the given equation, that equation considered previously, we get this equation, this set of equations, and eliminating the constants A0, A1, eliminating the constant A0, E0, Q0, and I0, we get this is the initial reproduction number. And putting these values, we get in Spain case, up to this date, the spread, the disease was spread, when this increased, then it was decreased. And we find the value of zeta from the slope of this line. And our case, using MATLAB package, we found the value of zeta is this, plus minus this day inverse, and using these values in this here, in this R0, we got the value of R0 in the range 5.15 to 5.84. Now, the effective reproduction number. The effective reproduction number, we all now well known about the reproduction number. And when the ICMR of our country, in the initial stage, declared every day the basic reproduction number of our country is 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3.5, this type was there. That is, the basic reproduction number usually changes with respect to the time. When the number of infected population increases, the basic reproduction number may increase or may decrease. So we found the effective basic reproduction number, that is the basic reproduction number per day using the real data and this formula. Here BT is the new cases in the teeth day, and GT is the generation interval distribution function. And GT satisfies this equation. GT is equal to this function where P1, P2, P3 is the death rate of the corresponding four class, that is A, E, Q, I. This elimination rate of that four class. And this figure is the corresponding effective basic reproduction number. Now, we use the optimal control analysis, that is the effect of lockdown. Time is okay, how many times? Pooja?
Yes, sir. 5 to 10 more minutes will be okay, sir.
Okay. Now the idea of lockdown will be discussed here. Here, the rate of incidence was alpha A plus beta SI. Now, if we implement the lockdown, that is, if we restrict the movement of the susceptible people, that is common people, then the common people, the interaction of the common people with the infected population will decrease. In our case, initially it was alpha SA plus beta SI. If U1 into AS pupil, that is U1 portion of the pupil, follow the lockdown, then U1 into AS pupil will follow the total lockdown, then 1 minus U1 into AS pupil will not follow the lockdown for the asymptomatic case. And similarly, beta into 1 minus UTIS portion will not follow the lockdown for the hospitalized case. And if we able to increase U1, U2 both towards 1, then the spreading will decrease. And then the system of equation reduced to this form. This is the reduced equation. This is the effect of lockdown. This is U1 for the asymptomatic case, and this is U2 for the hospitalized case. And to use the to describe the optimal control problem, we construct the functional considering this function, this form. This is the U1, U2 is the corresponding our control. Now I am discarding this. Now this is the entropy. This is the Hamiltonian, and we consider the Hamiltonian considering the integrand of the corresponding this functional, and the considering the corresponding adjoint variable lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 with the corresponding to the variables each. Then the adjoint variable lambda satisfy the sixth equation, lambda 1 by t equal to del s by del s cost per corresponding variable, and this is the equation with the transversal condition lambda I both are, that is, if I take target after t days, the disease will eliminate, then lambda I t is equal to 0, and using the corresponding optimality condition, we obtain U1 equal to this and U2 equal to this. Now we will use to find it the numerically. Exposed class, quarantine class, asymptomatic class, and infected class. Well, lockdown is considered or not. In our figure, if lockdown is not introduced, then the red mark line, and when lockdown introduced, that is control is used, then this is the blue line. Now, when the lockdown was not introduced, the number of SIA and Q class, both all are higher when the lockdown is implemented. That is the blue line. Okay. Any question? This is end of my lecture.
Okay, sir. Thank you, Dr. Ghosh, for such an informative speech. You have explained very vividly how susceptible infectious recovered framework can forecast the death rate and stabilize social economy. But of course, social awareness is of utmost importance. And sir, I am really very sorry for the interference caused during your lecture. And definitely we have some questions. With your due permission, I will move over to the question answer session. Just a second, sir. Just a second, sir, I will be. He's asking what will happen when R0 equal to 1. Here is R0 equal to 1 a bifurcation point?
Yeah. Okay. I seen the question. R0, we know for the epidemic model, when R0 less than 1, the disease equilibrium point is stable, and when R0 greater than 1, the disease equilibrium point is unstable, and then a endemic equilibrium point, at least one endemic equilibrium point arises there. If the forward bifurcation occurs, that is when one endemic equilibrium point arises, when for R0 greater than 1, then R0 equal to 1 is the bifurcation point, and this type of bifurcation usually follow the transcritical bifurcation. Following the transcritical bifurcation, one stable endemic equilibrium point generates, and the stable disease equilibrium points become unstable. And for backward bifurcation, R0 equal to 1 is an also the bifurcation point, but at r0 equal to 1, the system experiences the backward bifurcation. That is, there exists another critical value of the basic reproduction number, which is also less than 1. In that range, there exists another endemic equilibrium point other than the disease-free equilibrium point. So, r0 equal to 1 is most important from the epidemiological point of view. But in reality, this is a rare case where r0 equal to 1 occurs. Okay. Okay, your microphone is off. Pooja.
Okay, sorry. Thank you so much for the lucid explanation from your side, sir. So I would like to invite Dr. Mithali Bachar, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, for putting forward the next question. Mithali.
Thank you, Pooja. The next question is from R.P. Chauhan. He is asking, which class of population represented by Q in the model?
The Q class is the quantine class. That is, those pupil may follow some those pupil may follow some symptom or may not follow the symptom, but they come in the interaction with the infected pupil. In this situation, we put those pupil in the quantine center. So the Q class is the quantine class. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Pooja, over to you.
Okay. The next question has been posted by Rameshwar Mishra. Is there any epidemic model which doesn't exhibit bifurcation?
In reality, in hard reality, for epidemic case, the number of the infection first increases, then it decreases. After it reaches a peak point, then it decreases. But mathematically, we can represent different type of bifurcation. But what will happen in the real case, I have no knowledge about that. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much, sir, for your explanation. Mithali, over to you.
Okay, the next two question is also from R.P. Chauhan. He is asking, what is the role of the disease-free equilibrium and endemic equilibrium point in final estimation of model dynamics?
Okay, the disease-free equilibrium point plays most important part for obtaining the final estimation of the final size of the estimation of final size of the infection, but the endemic equilibrium point usually in reality endemic equilibrium point exists, but this is rare case. So the disease equilibrium point play most important part for the final size. Okay.
Sir, the last question for today is
hello,
has
sir.
Been posted by. Sir,
you are not audible.
Sir?
Okay, I'm audible.
Yes, sir. The last question has been posted by Harindra Singh. Why do we use optimal control? The estimated results already matched with the real data.
Okay. Optimal control will be used in modeling purpose. Suppose I have a medical facility and our target is to eliminate the disease from the system after some time. In my model, I already shown here the T, capital T, that is lambda IT. If I take target after T years, the T date, T day or T month, I will, the planner, that is the government or the planning society, they who are trying to control the disease, they target after 2 years the disease will eliminate from the system. In this situation, the optimal control is used. We know that polio, the polio for UNESCO take target to eliminate the polio from the society, from the world up in between 2010. So T is the target point, and in this situation we take the optimal control policy. And another important issue, using optimal control policy we can minimize the total cost, that is we can minimize cost for implementation of the treatment facility and any other facility for controlling the disease. So the optimal control is most important for the epidemic system.
Okay. thank you sir for the lucid explanation from your side. Actually we have many more questions from the participants, but due to the paucity of time I think it's better to stop here. What we can do is that with your due permission I can share your email ID with the participants. They can
contact
you. Thank you so much for your consent. Participants who
thank you sir
We will be in touch with you after this webinar. Thank you so much, sir. You can stop presenting and enjoy the second speaker's lecture.
Yeah. I just said we'll now.
Yes, sir. So now it's time for the second session. Now may I please welcome Dr. Mitali Bachar, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, DBM, for introducing our second speaker. Mitali, over to you.
Thank you, Pooja. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon to our respected resource persons, our respected principal sir, participants all over the country and abroad, my dear students, my colleagues, and our technical team, especially Dr. Ajay. Before Dr. Vishwas enlightened us by his valuable talk, I would like to introduce you. Dr. Mohammad Haidar Ali Vishwas is currently working as Professor of Mathematics at Science, Engineering and Technology School, Khulna University, Bangladesh. He obtained his PhD in Electrical and Computer Engineering from University of Porto, Portugal in 2013, and MPhil in Mathematics from University of Rajshahi, Bangladesh in 2008. His present research interests include optimal control of weak constraint, non-smooth analysis, mathematical modeling, mathematical biology and biomedicine, epidemiology of infectious disease. He has published 3 book chapters and more than 100 research papers in national and international journals. Lifetime as well as several members of several professional societies as research organizers, like Bangladesh Mathematical Society, Asiatic Society of Bangladesh, European Mathematical Society, Society of Mathematical Biology, etc. Dr. Vishwas is presently serving as the President of Bangladesh Society for Mathematical Biology for the year 2020 to 2024. On behalf of Department of Mathematics, Dinobandhu Mohammad, we wish a healthy and prosperous life for him. Welcome, Dr. Vishwas, the virtual platform. Over to you, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Are you there?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, so I can find the sharing option.
Okay, sir, take your time.
Hello.
But sharing option is not appearing here.
Sharing, sir, the right side. Hello.
Okay, Okay, let's, yeah.
Yes.
Now I appearing, I am trying.
Ojoy, please guide, sir. Ojoy.
Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Yes.
Sir,
yes, yes.
On the right hand side corner, there are three.
Yeah, I already give the sharing, but okay. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so. So now it's screen is appearing. I'm trying to read that. Is that appearing?
Yes. No, sir. Still not appearing.
But I saw that it is appearing.
Oh.
Not yet?
No, sir. Not yet.
No, sir. Even not. The presentation is not visible.
Now, sir, coming. It's coming.
Okay.
Yeah?
Now.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I am giving the full screen. Then it's yes. Okay. Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The presentation is visible.
Okay, thank you so much. And first of all, I would like to express my gratitude to the Dinobandhu College, especially to the principal for inviting me, participants with our colleagues who are working in this area or in several areas during this pandemic time. So, also, thanks to Dr. Uttam. He is working with me as a collaborator in optimal control theory. So there are many others colleagues here. I know. I saw Kaushik Ghosh also, and I don't know he is now still here. For everybody, I would like to give a lot of thanks for attending this webinar because we are facing a great health hazard during the whole globe. And during this time, actually we are restricted to stay in our home, most cases. In that time, this event is actually play its important role to all the participants, especially with working our students and some other researchers and colleagues in this area. So, and that, yes, this is why I am so much grateful to the organizer for inviting me to this event. So here actually we are very much concerned about epidemic or infectious disease because Uttamadandi said that infectious disease actually it is a sudden outbreak. It comes for a short period of time. So in that case, people are so much concern about this type of disease, even some epidemic or pandemic, in both of case. But there is a lot of disease for the chronic case, which kills a lot of lives the whole world, from the whole world globally. And there are some infectious and non-infectious disease was doing, but for the due to the long time sustaining in the society, so we are not so much care about that. But in that case, there is several disease like non-communicable disease, one of the non-communicable disease is like a cancer. And it is thought that cancer is actually a second cause of mortality globally. And it takes a huge lives over the year and even every year. So that's why I am sharing some of my research working in this area, actually how cancer evolves in the inside the body of a patient.
Hello.
Hello. Participants, sorry for the temporary technical glitch. Please bear with us. We are trying to connect with the speaker. I think he got disconnected. Sir got disconnected?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
He got disconnected.
Mitali ma'am, please call.
Mitali.
Yes.
Participants, we are trying to reconnect with sir. Please bear with us. This is only a temporary technical glitch. Yes, absolutely. A participant is writing, no problem. It's just a technical issue. This is actually the shortcoming of online platform. It definitely brings us close together, but these are some of the disadvantages we have to face. So please bear with us. We are trying to reconnect.
Sir, I cannot connect with the Professor Haider Ali Bishash. Please give me some time more.
We appreciate your patience. Thank you for bearing with us. Mithali ma'am is trying to reconnect with the speaker. Please, I request the participants not to leave the platform because sir is definitely going to enlighten us with his wonderful talk when we will be able to reconnect with him. So please have patience and do not leave the platform. It's my earnest request. Yes, Rajeev sir, as you have written that we hope we will enjoy sir's presentation. I assure you, once we get reconnected with him, you won't be disappointed. He's going to speak, he's going to illuminate us regarding a new technology in cancer treatment. So definitely you won't be disappointed. All the participants are requested to stay with us. Please don't leave the platform. And please bear with us. Your patience is highly appreciated from our side.
হ্যাঁ সুজিদা
Yes, Mithali, what is the status?
ওনাকে আর কি লিভ করতে
হবে। দ্যাট ইজ অলরেডি প্রেজেন্টিং দা প্রেজেন্টেশন।
ওনাকে লিভ করতে হবে মানে লিভ করে আবার ঢুকতে হবে।
হ্যালো। আই ডোন্ট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড।
নাও উনি তো ডিসকানেক্টেড হয়ে গেছেন। প্রেজেন্ট করতে হবে না বন্ধ করতে হবে ওনাকে প্রেজেন্টেশন বন্ধ করে।
হি ইজ সাম প্রবলেম হি ইজ নট হিয়ার।
প্রেজেন্টেশন বন্ধ করে আবার কানেক্ট করতে হবে।
আদার দিস
I am talking with Sujitda. Hello.
Okay, okay.
Sujitda, hello. Unake presentation bondo korte hobe, bondo kore abar on korte hobe, ha. Hello.
Rajiv Kormokar, yes, you are asking for the PDF files of the presentation. We will take the consent of the speakers and if possible, we can share it with you.
Sir, এটা বন্ধ করে মানে পুরোটা মানে বেরিয়ে গিয়ে আবার ঢুকতে হবে. প্রেজেন্টিং হচ্ছে না. মানে ওটা একটু বল তাড়াতাড়ি. হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ. ঠিক আছে.
And the feedback link will be provided after this session. Please have patience and bear with us. Actually, he's from Bangladesh and maybe he's having trouble connecting with us. So please bear with us and sorry for the interruption.
Hello, Mitali.
Hello.
Please bear with us. Sorry for the interruption.
What's the problem?
Sir?
Hello. Hello.
Hello, Mitali. What's the problem?
Sir is disconnected now. He's leave from the Google Meet.
Whether he's trying?
Yes.
Hello?
438, sir.
Hello?
Hello.
Sir? Professor Hajar sir will back within 3 or 4 minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, sir.
Ajay sir.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Ajay sir.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Please issue the that form. I mean
feedback form. Feedback.
Feedback form.
I will just upload the feedback.
Please issue the feedback form.
Yes, I will give it in the chat box.
Okay.
After. Hello. Hello, Mitali. Hello. Haan, bolchi je ki holo? Ei to eshe gechen, eshe gechen. Hi. Yes. Sir is back again. Hello. Hello, sir. Welcome again.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Hearing?
Yes, sir.
Welcome, sir. Thank you.
Welcome, sir.
Okay, so I'm sorry because I was disconnected. I don't know. I did not understand that. Well, I am already disconnected.
Yes,
because
sir.
I am going to present.
Yes, sir. Now.
Okay, sir. Welcome, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Now, sir, just present.
Just wait, I am sharing again. And
yes, sir.
Actually, due to bad network thing, I think this problem.
Yes, sir, this is no problem.
Is visible now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You are visible.
Yes, sir. The presentation is visible okay. Now. Yes, sir. It's all right.
Okay, sir. Visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so shall I start from the beginning?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I start again from the beginning because most of the case I think I was disconnected from the audience. So the topic is optimal control technique to modeling engineered immunocell therapy for cancer treatment, because cancer is actually the second leading cause of mortality globally. But it is a chronic disease, so it's sustaining for a long time in the society. So we are not so much care about that. But we are very much caring about the recent outbreak of infectious disease. But actually cancer kills a lot of lives more than an epidemic disease, than a cancer cell, cancer kill our lives in every year globally. So just here I am sharing one of my research regarding the treatment for the cancer. And applying two type of immunocell therapy, and another is immunoboosting drug for the treatment. So here actually there's some motivational explanation about this type of disease with objectives and background. And then we formulate mathematically how this disease is transmitted, how this disease is propagated inside the body, and how it interacts inside the body with the immunocell and the cancer cell. And then we apply two broad strategy, which is called the engineered T-cell therapy and the immunoboosting drugs. And then the model will be formulated newly with optimal control technique.
Sir, your presentation is not visible.
Are you left with it? হ্যাঁ এই স্যার আবার লেফট হয়ে গেছেন হ্যালো হ্যাঁ এই ফোন করেন একটু তাড়াতাড়ি এক্ষুনি হ্যাঁ এক্ষুনি কি হচ্ছে এটা
We just want feedback link. dot use geosim.
Hello, Ajoy.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Where is Ajoy? Where is Mitali?
Mitali is calling.
Where is Mitali? Yeah.
Mitali is calling the calling the speaker. And
Sir, I am there.
Sir.
Okay.
Again disconnected. That's why Mitali is.
Let's wait for some time.
There's
Let's
a,
wait.
There's
for
a major
some
problem.
Time. Yeah, yeah. This is okay. A major problem.
He's connecting again. Yes, yes. He's visible now. Yes, sir. Welcome.
Okay.
1 second, sir.
Okay.
Welcome, sir. Welcome, sir. 1 second.
Okay, thank you. But I don't know why I'm disconnected several times. It is maybe the network problem.
Yes, sir. Maybe the network problem.
What is GeoSIM?
Automate. I'm sharing again the full screen.
Yes, sir.
This is visible again?
No, sir. Still not visible. Yes, sir.
Hello, Mitali.
Yes, sir. No, sir. You are visible now.
Is okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
This is okay now.
Your presentation is visible now.
And
sir.
The screen is okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay, so I will start in the present phase, or I will go back in the beginning.
No, no sir, this will look. Hello, sir, this will be okay, sir.
Hi, are you hearing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Okay, so thank you everybody again for your patience because I don't know why I am disconnecting. So now here again, cancer. Actually, I am talking about the cancer is. A non-communicable disease, and it is a very global, alarming, and threatening issue to achieve the Sustainable Development Goal because it is estimated that 9.6 million deaths already in 2008. So it is one per six people in the globally, and cancer is collectively responsible actually for 71% of total death worldwide. So it is alarming, and it is also estimated by the World Health Organization that. By 2040, 29.4 million people will be diagnosed by the cancer. It is global, I mean. But actually, it is a hope that cancer now can be cured if it is detected early and undergone a sustainable, effective treatment plan. So this is actually our target to show a treatment, how it can be treated by using some cell therapy. So I am talking about a very dangerous cancer, oncogenic cancer. It is called the blood disorder, especially happen in the child. It is a common type of cancer in child. It is called the leukemia. So leukemia is very, globally it is very alarming. And in 2022, 60,530 people are expected to be diagnosed with this leukemia. And 2020 actually, 23,000 people are expected to die only by this leukemia disease. So it is very alarming, and we need actually some special type of treatment strategy is now in present century. This type of therapy actually is called immunotherapy, and this immunotherapy actually is done with some engineered T cell. I will discuss this type of treatment in our next slide. So just here presenting at the present scenario of leukemia only in the USA. You can see in the first figure, only in the USA, it is very alarming and it is growing up. And in the globally, in the second figure, in 2000 up to 2017, because it is growing up, the global situation of this leukemia cancer. So our objective here actually to understand how mathematics, how biomathematical model can be applied to describe this type of disease inside of body. Because actually, you know, cancer is a non-communicable disease and it is not infectious, but it is a chronic disease and actually it happens inside our body. So how cancer cell is interacted with other cell and our immune system. So this type of happening will be addressed by mathematical model, and then we will apply two control strategy, which we call it here two type of treatment strategy. One is the most effective in the present time. It is called the engineered T cell therapy, and another is the cancer suppressing drug. That is cancer suppressing some drugs, because also we need also drug to sustain for the cancer patient. Our aim is here to increase our immunity of the susceptible population so that they can fight. That is, they means our CD cell, our immuno cell can fight against the cancer cell to protect or to prevent our patient for a long time life expectancy. So here actually I am giving some background of this cancer cell, how it affect. You know, our bone marrow actually is very important to produce our cell. We bone marrow produce three type of cell, all these red blood cells, white blood cells and the platelets. But white blood cells also composed of two type of cell. It is called the spleen and the lymph nodes. But what happens when leukemia happens? When the leukemia is diagnosed, in that case our bone marrow cannot produce very healthy cell, and also spleen and lymph nodes cannot produce our healthy cell. In that case, millions of abnormal and immature white blood cells are produced, and for this case, no cell, that is red blood cell, white blood cells and platelets, cannot do their normal functions when the leukemia happened, when the leukemia is diagnosed. And you can see here a schematic diagram, that is the microscopic appearance of our cell. When it is the normal cell, it looks like very nice, but when the leukemia happens, you can see our white blood cells become very abnormal in this situation. And this is the cell division actually. It happens inside the body. When normal cell is divided, it produces several healthy cells, but sometimes they also produce some abnormal cells, but it is actually is mixed with our blood and then go outside. But when it is infected by some cancer cell, in that case a lot of abnormal cell is produced. And this is actually called the uncontrolled growth of our body, uncontrolled growth of our cell, and it is actually the case of cancer. So what is our aim here actually? We propose here, we will show the treatment protocol, how cancer is actually treated. In the present time, there are several types of cancer treatment which doctors can apply for the treatment of the cancer. It can be said that surgery with chemotherapy, radiotherapy, targeted cell therapy. So there is a lot of therapies, and also some drugs is used for the cancer cell depending on the stage of the cancer. But anti-cancer immunotherapy is the present time is very important, is a growing treatment strategy presently. It is called actually immunotherapy, but how it works and how it can be defined with some other therapies. So here you can see our immunotherapy actually is that kind of therapy. It is actually another type of chemotherapy, but in that case we don't kill our pathogen in the body, but we also help increasing the long-term internal resistance of our immune system so that the body itself can fight against the virus. This type of therapy we call anti-cancer therapy, and actually it is also called the adaptive cell therapy. It is now present time very promising a treatment strategy now for the cancer. It is called the somatic antigen receptor. It is called the CAR T cell therapy, and in the same name engineered T cell therapy, because in this case our immune cells are nurtured and are making engineered, and then we apply these engineered cell to kill the cancer therapy. So there are many other therapies also, oncolytic virotherapy. So I am talking today is engineering T cell therapy. So here actually a promising treatment approach of cancer we call is already engineered T cell therapy. Engineered T cell actually locates cancer cell and kills them without damaging our healthy cell. Because you know, when we use the chemotherapy, a lot of side effects happen inside the body for the patient. So this is a lot of side health hazard in that case. But when we usually the natural treatment, engineered T cell therapy, so they cannot kill any healthy cell. So engineered T cell therapy is very promising in present time. They don't only destroy the cell directly, but also stimulate the host anti-tumor immune system response. At 3% remission rate have been achieved by this type of therapy for the standard treatment case. So there is a lot of promising evidence for this type of therapeutic treatment of the cancer. And how it works, you can see this is the figure for the internal, for the microscopic, how the cell, engineered T cell, you can see the engineered T cell or CAR T cell is radon. This radon is the CAR T cell. When it is engineered, because how it works, you can take a healthy cell, what is called the immunocell, and then this cell is engineered or nurtured in a microbiology lab, and after then when it is stimulated, then it is replaced again in the body. And in that case, this engineered T cell or CAR T cell attack and the find out the leukemia cell. You can see the yellow one is the leukemia cell, and this it is attacking, and then it kills all the cancer cell, search the cancer cell and kill this cancer cell from the body. So this is a very effective way without damaging any healthy cell or without making any health hazard for our patient. So here actually we propose a model how finally the cell can be divided in the three compartments, because this type of disease actually is composed some compartmental stages. So here we call uncontrolled is our susceptible cells, because all T cell, that is white blood cell, we call white blood cell actually the susceptible cell, because this cell is affected by the cancer cell. And when this cell comes from the bone marrow, it is called the recruit rate. At a recruit rate, it comes in the susceptible one. And after, it has also, because every cell has some natural death, so this cell has some natural death. But when this cell is infected by some cancer cell, this is called the infection, rate of infection. So rate of infection is beta, is very important. And then immediately it goes in the infected cell. But when the infected cell, maybe some recover, have some, using some drug or naturally some infected, it immediately goes our immune cell and immune cell development, but it has also some natural death rate. And also infected cell have some natural death rate. So very simple deterministic model, you can see from the figure. And we don't use any control strategy here. That is, we are not using any treatment strategy. We are just proposing how the cell is interconnected with the cancer cell and how it works inside the patient. And in that case, you can see here very three system of differential equation, because differential equation is the best way to represent any dynamical system over the time, because with the time here evolution, so there's our system can be represented in this way. You can see here the susceptible cell can be modeled as the recruit rate A minus A naught S. A naught is the natural death rate and beta is the infection. So when susceptible is a close contact with the cell of infected, then it becomes immediately it goes from S and it enters in I. So it is the infected arm. And this infected cell has natural death as well as the cancer cell, the disease into death rate. So immediately this into death rate, it will come here. And our when it is recovered some case, it will come in the our immunocell. And it when necessarily when it is died, so it will come, it will appear, this disappear from this cell. So this is the three compartmental cancer model to represent our cell virus, our cell and immunocell interaction inside the in a patient. And as usual, as Dr. Uttam has discussed in his talk, that every model we actually need to verify whether this model have solution and whether the solution is unique or not. So that means we need some theoretical approach, but we also need some theoretical approach and we prove some equilibrium state in that case. And you know that basic reproduction number is important, what is the already discussed in the previous speaker. So disease free is that case when there is no disease. In our case, we consider when there is no cancer. So only the susceptible term will appear here and the other two term is zero. But when the epidemic equilibrium case, the three cell is existing in this system. In that case, a sister, I star and W, that is susceptible, infectious, and our immunocell, both the case can be calculated in this way. And we can also test the stability in both disease-free and endemic case using this type of theory, because the theory is already discussed by Dr. Uttam. And it is actually the case for the epidemic or non-epidemic model, that is for the communicable disease or non-communicable disease, all type of disease, this theory plays a very important role. So how it is sustaining the society or how the disease can be die out from the society. So now we will show here just our without control model. You can see the time series for the three susceptible case, the three specific case. This is susceptible, it is actually going up, but infected cell is going up. When susceptible is going down, it is actually is going up, because you know the susceptible case, when it is infected by other cell, the susceptibility is going down. Infection is susceptibility is going down and the infected is going rise. And also our immunocell is going down. So this figure actually shows, because treatment is very necessary according to this figure. It is the normal, it is the usual structure in our body of our cell and immunosystem representation. And we just verify how it works, because it is the rate of infection, beta is the rate of infection. When beta is increasing, you see, when beta is increasing, our susceptible population is increasing, because it is decreasing, you see. Because when beta is increasing, susceptible is decreasing, because they are getting infected in that case. But when beta is increasing, you see, infection is going rise. The infection, it is, you see, this is the beta 1. Beta 1 is rising and the infection is rising. So this is the normal structure. This is the variation of the immunocell, because our immunocell is also going down. You can see the maroon one. The immunocell is going down. When the infection rate is high, the immunocell is going down, is the last one. So actually this is the normal phenomena of a patient inside the body with the susceptible cell, immunocell, and or the cancer cell. This is also the immunocell. The rate of alpha, because alpha, you see alpha, the recovery rate. When the recovery rate is high, then in that case, immunocell is going up. You see, when the recovery rate we can rise, then our immunocell is rising up. So actually we need treatment. We need, it indicates that a proper treatment or proper control strategy should be applied so that a cancer patient can be cured or a cancer patient can sustain for a long time. So now, on this basis, we will propose this model in terms of optimal control technique. Here, what is the optimal control? We use E1 and E2. This is another two variable, not susceptible is also variable, and it is called the escape variable. And E1 and E2, the two other variables, it is called the control variable. So both two variables will present here and will play a role, significant role, because you see here, when we use E1, E1 is the engineered T cell therapy, because engineered T cell is the natural treatment strategy for increasing our immunity inside the body. And when it is already infected, then we use some drugs or some other therapy, and then the infected cell can be healed, and it goes, our immune cell can be developed. So both the case, our immune cell, we want to maximize our immune cell, and we want to minimize the infected cell. So this is the target of with control, and model can be formulated in this same similar way, because you can see here is also here three complementary model, and the last three part was our model without control, and this second last one is E1S. It is actually the control, the problem with control. This control is actually our engineered T cell therapy. This engineered T cell therapy immediately goes to increase our immune system or our immune cell. And also U2I, when we use some drugs that is the immunoboosting drugs, that cancer cell can be killed and it can be developed our immune cell as usual. So immune cell looks like this type of system looks like this one. And objective here, because all type of optimization problem, or we actually either maximize or minimize, so we have also some objective function subject to some constraint. So there are some difference with optimization and optimal control problem, because we are talking about here a optimal control problem. Optimal control, actually some difference with optimization is it deals with dynamic objective function. But in objective optimization, normal optimization problem, it deals with the algebraic function. So this is the main difference. And here also, as usual, we have some objective function. We call it cost functional. This is the minimize, that is, we want to minimize our infected cell, because our cancer cell should be minimized. And at the same time, we want to minimize our systematic cost of the control, because all the therapeutic treatment, it needs a lot of costing. Also, U2, another control, is called the immunoboosting drugs. So for the drugs, we also need a lot of costing. So all this costing should be minimized. At the same time, our infected cell should be minimized. This is actually the objective function. And with the satisfying with these three type of constraint of the dynamic constraint, with the initial condition is like this one. So this is our optimal control problem, and this control problem looks like this pattern. This is actually the pattern of optimal control problem, because I am not discussing actually the theoretical development of the optimal control, because it needs another talk actually, because optimal control is literature and is theoretical development. We develop all this type of theory, and then we apply this type of theory in the application in biomedical system or in biological system. So this problem is formulated in optimal control. This is the objective function, minimize J. This objective function actually called the Lagrange type or integral type objective function, subject to the dynamic constraint. It is, you see, X dot. This is our dynamics of the three differential equation. And another constraint is U, because U is also constrained with a measurable integrable set. And this set actually takes values, U takes values from 0 to 1, because when The control, we don't use any control. We don't use any therapeutic treatment, or we don't use any immunoboosting drug. Then in that case, U1 and U2 both zero. But when we use that therapeutic treatment, or engineered T-cell therapy, or immunoboosted drugs, then in that case, we call U is one, because the probabilistic sense, U is maximum one, and U is minimum is zero. And also, X naught is the initial condition, because initially, there is also some susceptible cell, also some infected cell, because when cancer is already happened, then there are a lot of in cancer cell, and also in our immuno cell. So three type of cell also existing in the body. So this is the initial condition. So this is actually described in this way. Here you can see, and this problem is written in optimal control problem. But optimal control, this is a basic need to verify how this optimal control problem has a solution, and how this optimal control problem has a unique solution. So there is also some theoretical proof of this type of problem. But we can prove this. It is called the characterization of optimal control technique. And in that case, we actually need to define Hamiltonian, because Hamiltonian is closely connected with our objective function. Because you see here, IT and this part, both this three part, it is our objective function, and this last part is from lambda I and GI, it is our the dynamic constant, because you see Z is the dynamic constant. So Hamiltonians can be defined in this way, and under the Bessel Hamiltonian, actually there is a set of necessary conditions for the solution of this type of problem, and this set of necessary condition actually is called the maximum principle or minimum principle, which was discovered by Pontry again, because Pontry again is a Russian mathematician. He and with his collaborators first discovered this type of set of necessary condition for the optimal control problem, and it is a milestone actually in optimal control theory. There is a lot of development afterwards, but this is the base for the solution of optimal control problem. So this set of condition is actually, one is optimality condition. This optimality condition is assessed by differentiating partially Hamiltonian with respect to the control, and this control should be zero. This differential should be zero at the point of optimal control solution, that is U1 suman U1 star. So in this case, we can solve this type of optimal solution for U1 star and U2 star using these two equations. And another equation is the adjoint equation. Adjoint equation is actually achieved by differentiating A with respect to the state variable. So this is a state variable S dot, and also we have some another I dot and lambda S A dot and lambda I dot and also lambda R dot for this type of three lambda W, like, so lambda W dot. This is actually the three state equation we can get from the optimal solution. And after solving analytically, the optimal solution is achieved in the three states, because when Hamiltonian the differentiation is greater than zero, and when it lies between 0 to 1, because you know that I already discussed, U takes values from 0 to 1, but when it is greater than zero and when it is less than zero, in that case, our solution looks like this. So in compact form, we can solve all this optimal solution. Here optimal solution is 2, because one is U1 and another is U2. So U1 star looks like this, and U2 star looks like this. So this is actually optimal solution we can achieve. So now we are at the ending stage of our talk, because here I will show the numerical results without solution, without control, and with control, how the strategy, how the treatment strategy can be achieved in a better way. Because you can see here our infected cell in the left, this figure looks, says our infected cell. When you use the control, what is our control? There are two controls. One control is U1, we call it immunoboosting drugs. We call the immunotherapeutic treatment. And U2 is actually the immunoboosting. So when U2 is inactive, that is when U2 is inactive in absence of immunoboosting drugs, when we don't use any immunoboosting drugs, in that case also our cell, immune cell, that is our infected cell, is going down. Only one control when we use, then also we get that our cell is going up without control, and with control the infected cell is going down. So that is the control strategy actually is working and it is effective, but only use one control. But when we use the another control, our immune cell looks like this. In that case, you see our immune cell is rising up very drastically, dramatically, because we are using control. What is U2 is not immunotherapeutic treatment. It is actually U1 is immunotherapeutic treatment. In that case, immunotherapeutic treatment, that is engineered T cell therapy using, then our immune cell is rising up. And as also, when we use the second control, another control, that is immunoboosting, when we use the immunoboosting drug, also our infected cell is rising with drug. But when we use drug, our cell also, immune system, that is the infected cell, is going down. So it also here, we can see that our control is working, that is control is effective. But also, it is here, is noticed that the control is only one control we are using again here. When we use the two controls, both controls, then it will be more effective in that case.
Hello?
It is also the same in our immune cell, because our immune cell, you can see, our immune cell without control is very very low. But when we use our control, then our immune cell is rising, rise up. You see, immune cell is highly rising up. But at the last test, it is going down. Why it is happening? Because you can see, there is some a resistance of the immune cell, because the resistance of the drug. Because we are using drug, our cell actually become resistant. In that case, actually, we need the multi-combination of the drugs. What is actually using now? The antiretroviral therapy. So in that case, antiretroviral therapy gives a good effect for the treatment of the immune system. But immunoboosting drugs, in this case, only immunoboosting drugs can happen. But in absence of immunoboosting, our immunotherapy gives good results, because immunotherapy is the natural treatment strategy. And now you can see here, we are using both controls. One is immunoboosting drugs, and another is our immunotherapy. So immunotherapy and immunoboosting drugs gives again the results. Our infected cell is going down, and also without control, the infected cell is rising up. So here is also this case, but both two controls are effective. When both controls are effective here, our immune cell, because we want to actually maximize our immune cell. Here you can see our immune cell is rising up, but without control, immune cell is very going down. So control is very essential in all the cases. And also now, finally, I just show here the basic reproduction number, the nature of basic reproduction number, because when the basic reproduction number is actually greater than 1, you can see the basic reproduction number is rising up. So this is the nature of the disease is pertaining in our case. But when the basic reproduction number is less than 1, you can see the less than 1, and it indicates that the disease can be terminated. But actually for the cancer, it is actually rising, it is actually growing, and it should be minimized using this internal or engineered T-cell therapy for the sustainable management of our patient, for the better treatment strategy. Just I am showing here the two case control, which one is more effective for the objective functional. So actually this is my talk I'm sharing for the treatment, latest treatment strategy for the engineered T cell in case of cancer patient. And there are a lot of strategies recently, but this is the most effective way of treatment for the cancer patient. And our results actually indicate, our study actually indicates that the combination of the two therapeutic treatment, one is engineered T cell therapy and another is the immunoboosting drugs, both is necessary, because when you use the engineered T cell therapy. At the same time, we also need use the some drugs because drugs minimizes our some side effects also. And also, when you use drugs, immunoboosting is the same time you can use the immunoboosting. You can use the immuno engineered T cell therapy. So this is actually the strategy we are using, and it can be actually how it can be achieved by this type of therapeutic treatment. For this case, actually, I can recommend, I can say that actually in that case, we actually need some collaboration with our patient, with the doctors who are treating our patient, and then we can have a specific scheduling for this type of therapeutic treatment and for using the immunoboosting drugs. So collaborative result may give more better strategic treatment strategy for the cancer patient. So this is actually, this result is very highly published actually in our very good recent publication in Journal of Applied Medicine Computation. So this unique results, it is a very good result for the treatment. And there are some other also papers. This results actually the model was formulated by my students. And so there is a group of research team of my lab is working here. And I also some other collaborative in different, there is also another Uttam Ghosh, I first beginning, and there is Shankar Roy, and Ketash in Delhi, and the, in some other case. And also some in other abroad, some researcher is only working in collaboration with me. So thank you everybody for patient. And I think due to the networking problem, somebody may have some problem for listening this talk, but I think we can share by email. If you have any questions, you can share with me by email or something like this. Then we can answer all type of questions and we can share our research with you. Thank you everybody and thank you all. If you have any questions, please share me.
Thank you, Dr. Ali, for your insightful speech and broadening our horizon towards mathematical modeling. It is evident that immune sir, due to shortage of time, I can only put forward one more question to you. Question posted by Khalid, why should we not go to mix therapy of as well as the conventional therapy? And what is the goal of therapy in the future?
Hello?
Okay.
Yes, hello.
Hello, should I repeat the question once
more? Yes.
Okay, so the question has been posted by Khalid Nazir. He's asking, why shouldn't we go through mixed therapy? And what is the role of local therapy in such model? Mixed therapy means both immunotherapy and the conventional chemotherapy.
So the question is, why you need
mixed therapy?
The therapy, right?
Yes, yes. Is it possible to use mixed therapy for cancer treatment? That's what he is asking.
Actually, thank you for the question. Actually, for the networking problem, I cannot hear the full questions. But so far, I understand. Therapeutic treatment actually is now the most effective treatment strategy for the cancer, because you know cancer is, if early detected, it is curable. Now, once upon a time, it was said that cancer has no cure, but present situation in present age, cancer actually many very dangerous cancer also curable. So it should be the main idea is if it is detected early, it can be cured. But only the treatment strategy is now using some therapy, it depends on the stage of the cancer. Because if it is early stage, you can use only some drugs, or you can use some chemotherapy or some radiotherapy. But radiotherapy or chemotherapy have a very side effect for our patient. You know, everybody, I think everybody have some ideas about cancer patient. When they take the therapy, they have some hair fallen and some other things for their body. But when we use this type of natural therapy, because natural therapy means our immunocell therapy, because actually we want to stimulate our immunosystem so that immunocell can detect our cancer cell and they can kill this cancer cell. And this is the case now is using and it is also have a promising start promising results for this treatment using this engineered T-cell therapy. So engineered T-cell therapy is not fully 100% is usable everywhere, because it is actually is not fully accessible for everybody. But it is now working globally, and already the FDA from the USA has approved this type of therapeutic treatment. FDA means it is the drug association for the USA. It is a global drug association. They can dominate in the treatment case for the cancer. And now recently they have approved this type of therapeutic treatment. So it indicates this is a promising now in the treatment for the cancer. So are you hearing me?
Okay, sir. Yeah, you are.
Thank you, Pooja. There is another question from Dr. Yes. Khalid Nazim. He is asking, what is the role of global stability in such models?
Actually, global stability, I don't show here the global stability, but global stability, actually, stability of the all type of modeling, especially for the disease and epidemic and pandemic disease, stability has some role in the in representing this type of model. But stability looks like local and global. But when we are very much concerned about the local stability, because when it is local, then it should have the global someone in some cases. Because you see, when there is a local minimum, so there are so many local minimum, but one local minimum should be global. So at least there are some results about the global stability. So when actually using optimal control technique, optimal control also some another variable which acts in the similar type. But in that case, there is some results, there is some theoretical approach to validity, to validate
the
optimal control. In this thing for that.
Sir, I want to ask, can we use your partial differential equation to formulate the problem?
Yeah. You can. We can also use some partial differential equation, because there is some lot of models of the optimal control. We can use partial differential equation. We can use delay differential equation, because sometimes.
So here in the partial differential equation, here just I want to know suppose coupled partial differential equation, then which parameters we have to use to suppose like del P by del T, del Q by del T, like tumor na. So here which parameters we have to use to formulate the coupled partial differential equation, 3-4 equations.
Yeah, but if you study the partial differential model, there are some other theoretical approach for validating this type of model, and you can see the Boltzmann model, Boltzmann maximum principle, because maximum principle you can use for the ordinary case and also some partial differential case. But we also partial differentiation for driving the optimality condition, because optimality condition we see yeah, there is a set of necessary condition. A set of necessary condition actually depends on the escape variables and the control variables. So actually we use the partial differentiation case, but also in that case the model can be used as the partial case to formulate this type of a chronic or cancer model.
Which particular parameters we have to consider? Which parameters?
Actually this depends on the parameter of that transmission of transmission of the cancer. This is the mechanism what is happening inside the body. So inside the body there are three type of cell I mentioned here. One cell is our helper cell, our T cell, what is called the white blood cell, and another is our immune cell, and another is the cancer cell. So this is the interaction actually between among the cell. So when one cell is infected by the other cell, so there should have some parameter, because how it is getting infected, what is the rate of this infection. In that case we actually need it, we can be this parameter can be determined actually from the patient who is treated by our doctor. So the doctor can say how this type of cell is infected by the susceptible cell is infected by the infected cell because
for a vascular tumor there is a proliferation quiescent and necrotic. So we prepare del P by del T, del Q by del T and del N by del T, these three for a vascular tumor we are use these partial derivatives, and we prepare coupled partial differential equation for a vascular tumor. So here is I want to know ki in the place of PQN which we have to use.
Sir, can
you give your email ID? Can we follow because in the numerical method, in the partial differential equation, I required the solution to solve the partial differential equation by finite difference method, and it discretized by Euler method, and then I am writing the code, MATLAB code, using MATLAB software. So for a vascular tumor I written the code to solve the coupled partial differential equation, but I am getting problem for vascular tumor. I solved a vascular tumor, but I am getting problem to solve the couple equation for vascular tumor.
Okay, so actually
if you have idea to sir, just I want to follow you. If you don't have any problem, sir.
Okay, so you can contact me by email or by contact cell. You can take the email number from the organizer, from the Mitali, or you can
tell them please send the chat box your mail ID and number or whatever.
Okay, so I will share your my email number and also my cell number. You can contact by
yes,
email.
Yes sir. Sure sir. Thank you. Thank you sir. Yeah, thank you sir. Thank you.
I think it's time to talk to overstep with the timing. So sir is going to share his email ID with the participants. Other please share your ID in the chat box. And I now welcome Dr. Shipra Dash, Associate Professor, Department of Mathematics, EPM, for hosting the vote of thanks.
ক্যান্সার তো ছিলই, এখন আরো কিছু শব্দ, করোনা, লকডাউন, স্যানিটাইজেশন, সোশ্যাল ডিস্টেন্সিং, সবাই আতঙ্কিত। তবে আশার কথা, কিছু মানুষ এই অজানা ভয় কাটিয়ে নিজেদের মতো করে যুদ্ধ করছেন মানব কল্যাণে। এই রকম দুজন মানুষকে আজ আমরা আমাদের মধ্যে পেয়েছিলাম। কলকাতা বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ের গণিত বিভাগের অধ্যাপক ডক্টর উত্তম ঘোষ এবং খুলনা বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ের গণিত বিভাগের অধ্যাপক ডক্টর মোহাম্মদ হায়দার আলী বিশ্বাস। নিজেদের গবেষণালব্ধ কিছু কথা, কিছু অভিজ্ঞতা তারা তুলে ধরেছে খুব সুন্দর সাবলীল ও যুক্তিনিষ্ঠ ভাবে। বনগাঁ দীনবন্ধু মহাবিদ্যালয়ের পক্ষ থেকে তাদের অসংখ্য অসংখ্য ধন্যবাদ। এই মূল্যবান বক্তব্য আমার মতো অনেককেই ভয়কে জয় করার সাহস দিয়েছে। এ যেন হঠাৎ আলোর ঝলকানি লেগে ঝলমল করে চিত্র। এই ওয়েবিনার আবারও প্রমাণ করলো জ্ঞান বিজ্ঞান চিরকালই মুক্ত, তাকে বেড়া দিয়ে ঘরে আটকে রাখা যাবে না। চিন্তা চেতনা মানুষের মধ্যে ছড়িয়ে পড়বেই যতই লকডাউন হোক না কেন। দেশে দেশে দিশে দিশে কর্মধারাধার সহস্রবিধ চরিতার্থতায় এই ওয়েবিনার সফল করার জন্য এখানে উপস্থিত সবাইকে দীনবন্ধু মহাবিদ্যালয়ের গণিত বিভাগের পক্ষ থেকে জানাই আন্তরিক অভিনন্দন ও ধন্যবাদ। ছাত্রছাত্রীদের জন্য রইল শুভেচ্ছা। আমি বিশেষভাবে ধন্যবাদ জানাতে চাই কলকাতা বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ের গণিত বিভাগের অধ্যাপক ডক্টর নান্টু সরকারকে, যার সহযোগিতা ছাড়া আমাদের পক্ষে এই ওয়েবিনার অর্গানাইজ করা খুব কঠিন হতো। ধন্যবাদ অর্গানাইজিং কমিটি ডক্টর জেনিত রায়, ডক্টর সুজিত কুমার কর, ডক্টর অজয় মল্লিক, ডক্টর পূজা পাল এবং আরো যারা নানাভাবে সাহায্য করেছেন সবাইকে। অজয়ের টেকনিক্যাল সাপোর্ট এবং পূজার সভা পরিচালনা আলাদাভাবে উল্লেখের দাবি রাখে। ধন্যবাদ আমার ডিপার্টমেন্টাল কলিগ ডক্টর মিতালী বাছারকে। মিতালী যেভাবে সমস্ত বিষয়টা সামলেছে তার জন্য ওকে ধন্যবাদ জানাই। সব শেষে আমি ধন্যবাদ জানাচ্ছি আমাদের কলেজের প্রিন্সিপাল ডক্টর বিশ্বজিৎ ঘোষকে, যিনি জোর না করলে উৎসাহ না দিলে না হতোই না। আমি শেষ করছি এই আশা নিয়ে আমাদের আবারও দেখা হবে। করোনা মানুষকে কিছুতেই শেষ করতে পারবে না, জয়ী আমরা হবই। আমাদের দেখা হোক মহামারী শেষে, আমাদের দেখা হোক জীবন ফিরে উঠে, আমাদের দেখা হোক জীবাণু ঘুমালে, আমাদের দেখা হোক সবুজ সকালে।
থ্যাংক ইউ শিপ্রামন, এত সুন্দর ভাবে ভোট অফ থ্যাংক দেওয়ার জন্য। I expect them to fill in their information correctly because these copies are specifically mailed to them. So now we have reached the last lap of this session. Principal sir, with your closing speech, we can end today's session. Sir?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Thank you, everybody. That's the end of the day. I'm closing the session, okay? Thank you, everybody. Bye.
Okay, everyone. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe.
Mitali.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
আমার দু তিনবার কেটে গেল আবার জয়েন করলাম।